What this project means to me is that it shows to ourselves and to future generations that we respect Stonehenge. What we see when we get there is the stone monument against a busy road. We hear the sound of traffic continuously 24 hours a day. Opening up the landscape will transform our experience of the monument and everything around it.
I mean, the traffic has got so bad now. People have been waiting for this for 30 years. For us to be getting something done at last is just brilliant news. The village will be more peaceful, but it'll be more like a village on Salisbury Plain should be.
Good network links is vital to how we operate. We do have lots of problems where vehicles are caught up on the 303, especially around the Stonehenge area.
The greatest impact for us as a business just means we can just move around a lot quicker. The tunnel, I think it's going to make a much quicker route and a much better infrastructure.
The A303 is part of a wider, broader process of resilience and the provision of a satisfactory road network between the entire South West Peninsula and London.
The project as a whole is going to really improve people's access to nature. They'll be able to move across the full extent of the World Heritage Site from a wildlife perspective, wildlife that can't get across the landscape. The scheme's going to enable them to do that.
To be able to see Stonehenge in that huge green space rather than having traffic going past it continually would give children a far greater sense of what it would have been like when it was built.
It would help us go out more because we would be able to explore more places.
We're looking forward to getting a better life and we'll get our village back.
We've got some really good things happening for wildlife and it's also going to be really great for people.
This will reach every element of the South West economy.
The overall result will be a vastly improved experience within the whole of the World Heritage Site, not just at Stonehenge.